don't know. I don't know. I just think it's a smart move.
Why?
And I think it's a smart move because then, you know, he can say that, hey, I'm doing what the fans want to do.
If you win this fight against Manny Pacquiao, who would you want next?
Like I said, I don't care, man. I really don't. I have a list of guys that I want to face. It's just, you know, I deal with what's in front of me. Manny Pacquiao's in front of me. I don't really think about what's next.
So who would give Floyd a tougher fight, a Khan or Maidana, just to follow up on Ellie's question?
I don't know, man. I don't know. Both of those fights are pretty tough. You know, I think they're good fights. Khan is very fast. Maidana applies a lot of pressure. And, you know, he boxes a little bit more since he's been with Robert Garcia. I see a little change in him, so.
What do you mean when you say Freddie Roach thinks he has you figured out? Can you elaborate on that?
Well, I just think that after the Pavonikov fight, you know, he saw how much damage Pavonikov did. And granted, the way I fought, they're going to try to make me fight Pacquiao. That's what I think.
Where do you stand in terms of training? Have you started full go camp? Are you warming up to it?
No, I start full go camp after, actually Monday. I start full-fledged camp. I'm going to do 8 weeks of hard work. Normally I do about 9 weeks. I'm going to do 8 weeks. I'm still in some pretty good shape.
A week from yesterday, you mean,
yeah?
Is it going to be in India?
I'm at my gym. I'm my own gym now.
Okay. Robert Garcia said that if he could choose one trainer to train him today, it would be Joel Diaz. What makes Joel Diaz such a good trainer?
Well, Joel Diaz is, he's real. He knows how, he talks to his fighters firmly. He's all business. And he's real. He lets you know you're losing the fight. You need to pick it up. Most trainers, they try to sugarcoat things and be like, oh, well, you know, you're doing okay, or you're winning the fight, and they're really not. You know what I mean? Joel's real. He's firm. He's aggressive with you. He knows how to motivate his fighters. And I'm telling you, Joel Diaz has saved me in numerous and numerous of fights, man, where I was hurt, or, you know, the first Pacquiao fight, he kept me alive in there. My whole corner did, man. But Joel was telling me, you know, ignore the pain, you know, ignore the pain, forget about the pain, you know, you're in a fight right now, we're gonna win this fight. So he's all positive and all positive vibes, man. And like most trainers tell the fighters what to do, Joel does that, but like he also wants to hear from me. And most trainers don't give their fighter an opportunity to tell him what's going on. So like after the first round at the Marquez fight, Joel says, tell me, baby, what do you see? And I say, he's solid. And he understands that what I mean. He understands because we speak in, you know, these terms when we're training. So he's solid, meaning like, hey, he's a tough cookie. He's very solid in every aspect. So then he gives me advice on what to do. So then I come back to the corner, you know, the second time, and he says, well, hey, this is what you need to do. He's solid, but he drop feints on him. Make him open up. So he guides me, but he wants my feedback as well. He can see from the outside, but like I'm in the ring fighting. I can say, Joel, I can't do that because of this. And he'll say, all right, well, do this and then do this.
You know, you can fight Pacquiao like the way you fought.